Hello and welcome back to One Hive TV. I'm your host, T. Wells. I appreciate you for joining us. Today we're going to take a look at a new partnership between Agave and DXDAO with the integration of the Carrot token into the money market protocol. Had a chance to sit down with DXDAO's John Kelleher as well as Monstrosity from the Agave team to learn more about how the protocol is using them to incentivize TVL, as well as a broader discussion about how KPI tokens can help optimize incentives throughout a DAO's ecosystem. Hey, John. Yeah, so can you tell us a little more about the start of the partnership between Agave and DXDAO regarding Carrot?
Green Hornet actually pinged me about using, like, I think he even posed the idea of trying to incentivize stuff with some kind of, like, you know, prediction market or conditions, right? And around that time, you know, folks at DXDAO had been just amongst the swapper squad, like, discussing this idea. So that there was, like, early, I think, validation to hear that, like, this desire for something like that from an external party. And that's how the conversation started. I think that was back in even like May or June of this year. So the way Agave is leveraging it right now is to incentivize capital coming into Agave, right? The TVL, the total value locked metric. And I think that's a natural thing that Carrot can be used for. So any type of protocol, whether it's a DeFi protocol or something else that wants to incentivize capital coming in, it's an easy thing to measure, right? So I think that's a natural fit for Carrot.
There are some people that have actually aped into Agave to collect these carrots and essentially gambling on getting a really high APR because they're collecting a great deal of carrots. And so if we do well above our threshold, those that were essentially loyal through the hard times are the ones that are going to get the greatest reward, right? So it's a dynamic about it that I don't think I gave that much thought, that it rewards those who are, you know, the most loyal also. You know, it's a risk reward thing though too, right? You know, they may not get anything for those carrots.
Right, so the rate of emissions of the carrots is tied to the current TVL, right? So if today the TVL is maybe sitting somewhere lower on that goal spectrum, you're actually earning relatively higher than you would be if it was higher up. And then the actual payout only gets determined in the last week, right? So, like, if the TVL jumps up in the last week and you had been farming it earlier in the month when it was lower, you're actually going to realize a higher rate of return, right? That's kind of what you're talking about here.
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool. Yeah.
Yeah. So there, nobody's getting these carrots right now except for the people that, you know, are farming it. And, you know, so they're getting a lot of carrots right now. They're arguably at this point in time, not worth anything, but, you know, if you roll the dice and the TVL jumps up in that last week, because it's just about the last week that all that matters. And so if we get the TVL in the last week, you know, then they could have hit big on their APRs.
Right. It's about giving tokens with a goal, right? And so there's a social component to that goal too, right? Like, if all of the folks who are earning these carrots, like, maybe they can work together to help achieve that goal, right? And so, yeah, I think the social, that goal, right, is relevant.
Got it. So assuming a carrot campaign such as the one on Agave is successful, where do carrot holders go to redeem them?
Right. So the redemption is support. I mean, I think in theory, redemption could be supported in any UI that wants to add that to, right? So if you know, Luigi and co wanted to add that to the Agave interface, that would be possible. But it's going to be like, you can do it on the Carrot UI, right? So, like, the Carrot UI itself, carrot.eth, and you can visit it without a Web3 wallet by just going to carrot.eth.link, or .limo is another service that you have to add on to the end to direct you to these ENS domains. But once you visit, that's like that website is geared towards the, you know, showing people who have carrots, like, what's going on with their carrots, right? Like, showing the stats about how progression is towards the goal, you know, measuring the metrics. So in Agave's case, like if you go, the measurement I think actually starts the last week of December. That's the week that the TVL actually matters in terms of determining how much gets paid out and what the ultimate result of that carrot campaign is. And so like that week you'll see a graph on that campaign, on the Agave campaign, showing the TVL each day. And that's also where you can go to redeem your carrots for the underlying tokens, which in Agave's case is actually like a symmetric pool token. Depending on how much of the goal is achieved, it's like a scalar range. So if it's below the low end, you don't get anything. But I think the 3 million TVL is the minimum goal. Anything above that, you're starting to get a portion of the rewards, all the way up to, I think, 12 million TVL. It's 100%.
Okay. And it's also the case, right, that users or projects can go and create their own, you know, custom carrot campaigns with specific parameters that they're looking for.
Yeah. And so that people understand when projects or people set up carrot campaigns, you can choose when the measurement period is. Like, so like the Agave campaign is taking an average of TVL over the last week of December, but they are distributing the carrot tokens, I think, since almost the beginning of the month, right, over basically the whole month and sort of that's up to anybody creating these campaigns. You can choose when the measurement time frame is, and then you have up to you how you and when the carrots get distributed.
Right. So, and like zooming out a bit, John, how would you sort of characterize the core use case for the carrot product, and what are you most excited about looking to the future?
I think it's actually sort of a building block for DAOs and for like scalable DAOs, like having these programmable incentives built into like the working model for organizations. I think that gets me really like excited, looking kind of like further out into the future. I think that's going to take a while to evolve. I think more for the near term, midterm, I'm excited to kind of see like yield farming 2.0, right? Just like, you know, seeing how DeFi tokens have been really hurt. And I think people are kind of asking whether, like, you know, questioning the wisdom of really aggressive yield farming. I think just seeing carrot get applied there and allowing DeFi projects to like be a little more focused on what they're trying to achieve with their growth marketing and their spend on that, and like seeing carrot help that, I think is what I'm excited about in the near term.
Well, and so we see this, it's immediate use case with Agave. It's the first protocol to be using carrot, my understanding, outside of DXDAO, which is awesome. What are some of the other use cases that you foresee and you sort of anticipate people adopting the carrot for?
Yeah, I think it's a great use case. It's giving incentives to work milestones, whether that's for a project or grant or even individual contributors within a DAO. It's like I think in the meta sense, the bigger problems we're trying to solve here with DAOs are how do we organize people in a flatter hierarchy in a more scalable, more decentralized way where you don't have, you know, ownership kind of like straight up the ladder to executives and boards and that kind of thing, where how do you set up systems that rely more on crypto economic incentives? And I think this is just a basic building block for crypto, right? A cornerstone of crypto is incentives, like crypto incentives, everything from Bitcoin mining, right, from the very beginning. You know, Bitcoin's emissions and transaction fees, those are incentivizing people to run miners, all the way up to yield farming, where that, you know, this token emissions are incentivizing people to deposit and use DeFi protocols, right? Like, it's all about these incentives. And I think that can be applied to how people actually work, and that will affect how people can organize. And really, I think it's sort of a building block for DAOs and where I think DAOs may be able to go.
Awesome. Yeah, I know I'm really interested to see how we might integrate a KPI options within the contributor circles for One Hive TV. So I have to think about that. Thanks again, John, for joining us to share a bit about the Carrot product. It's really excited to be working with DXDAO on this. And again, thanks, Monstro, of course, for sharing the Agave side. I look forward to speaking with both of you again soon.
Yeah, thanks, T-Wells.
Definitely. Thanks for having us.